Okay. Let's go to Hebrews 11. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. 3. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. By faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it, being dead, yet he speaks. By faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found, because God had translated him. For before his translation he had this testimony that he pleased God. But without faith it is impossible to please him, for he that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Verse 6, but without faith it is impossible to please God, for whoever comes to God must believe that God is, and that God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Amen. Without faith it is impossible to please God. Number one, God desires to be pleased, and the only way we can please him is by faith. Somewhere else in the Bible it says you cannot please God unless you are holy or pure. That is also true. And I want you to know, because you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, he has already made you holy and he has already made you pure. What we need to do is to walk in holiness and walk in the fear of the Lord. Your continual fellowship with Jesus Christ will continuously keep you holy and righteous. Hallelujah. But faith is something that we need to work out. Turn to your neighbor and say, I need to work out my faith. Amen. Hallelujah. You can see the term by faith and through faith in the Bible. Even yesterday's meeting, did you hear that man was mentioning that? That's awesome. Okay. What is by faith? By faith is God putting himself into your heart. I'm sorry. Through faith is when God puts himself into your heart. By faith is when you begin to use that faith to overcome. I have the faith of God. I work out that faith of God to heal you. I work out the faith that God has put in my heart to preach a message. I work out the faith that God has put in my heart to call out to some of you. Amen. Church, did you know that many times we call out things here? You know, many times I call out things here. Many times people are ashamed. I mean, they're embarrassed. I don't blame you, but they're embarrassed. But everything that I've ever called out here, somebody has always taken it up and called me later and said, Pastor, that is for you. You know, sometimes it can be very discouraging when you call this out and nobody owns it up. It can be very discouraging. But I have faith in me to tell me that whatever I have said is from the Lord. Even this morning I saw very clearly, I saw a stethoscope, I saw a lady, I saw all these things, and I understood that there was somebody who was given a choice by the doctor. You may live only up to so many years, or your disease may come back after so many years. Whatever it is, I want you to know, if you are a child of God, no disease is going to come back. I know it is for somebody, and probably you'll call me up later and say, point is, I do this by faith. Because I have God's faith in me, I also do it out by faith. God gives you faith so that you can work out faith. God gives you faith so that you will be able to do the works of God. Now, God is somebody who has given peace, and God expects you to work out peace. God has healed you. God expects you to work out healing. God has restored you. God expects you to work out healing. If God has given peace to you, he will help you to work it out. How many of you like to be partners with God to work out his work? When you say you are in the ministry, that means you are partnering with a great God to make sure that you continuously do what God is doing or what God has done. Healing is a great thing. Ministry is a great thing. You are actually working out the faith that God has given to you. Hallelujah. Turn with me quickly to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verses 11. Let's see how God has put something inside our heart. I said God has put faith in our heart, and we are going to please God by working it out. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Thank you, Lord. I'll tell you in a minute. First Corinthians. First Corinthians 2:12. Is that what we are? Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Can you read that with me, saints? Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Amen. What does it mean? I want you to focus on this word of. The Holy Spirit has a way of taking our attention and putting it on small things. Of. Say with me, of. What does of God mean? When I say, you know, I take this shirt off baby. I won't do it. Don't be embarrassed. Off baby. What does it mean? It already belongs to. So when I say God is giving us something of Him, that means He is putting in our heart something that belongs to Him. That is from His personality. That is from His very being. Alright? Now read that with that in mind. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. God has freely given to us something that belongs to Him. God has freely given to us faith. God has freely given to us the ability to heal. God has freely given to us peace. Peace. How many of you think you need a little more peace? Hallelujah. This word peace keeps coming back to my mouth and my mind again and again and again. Somebody who says, Lord, I can do with a double anointing of peace. Lift those hands up. Can we have a double anointing of peace? Yes. Don't keep your hands like that, you know. At least when you lift those hands up, people will know that I'm preaching the truth. And don't be embarrassed. I ask God for a lot of peace. A lot of peace. This morning I have news for you. Peace is already inside you. Because you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, peace is already inside you. And God is expecting you to work it out. Let me tell you about peace. God, Jesus is known as the Prince of. At the same time, it says elsewhere that we are called to be peacemakers. Those who make peace are known as. That means when there is a struggle, you know what I do? Where is my wife? Okay, when I fight with my wife, show. Sachyam boy. Somebody else's house, I'll say. So, you know, not my wife. Because I lose my testimony, you know. Pastor Sachyam boy. I make it a point, she makes a point. The minute we know we are going to talk about something, we are not going to agree. I make it a point, she makes it a point. We will not talk about it because we know if we talk about it any further, we definitely are not going to love each other sometime. Somebody said hallelujah. Because we both have the peace of God inside us, we both decide to work out that peace. Hello. Pastor, people will stop coming to the church from tomorrow. Next Sunday, pastors are fighting fast. God expects us to work out what God has worked inside. God is pleased when we work out what God has already worked inside. How many people understand this point, people of God? And God is pleased not because we keep on going back to Him and crying all the time. Lord, you know what? I shouldn't have done it. I didn't do it. I should have been, you know. God says, I understand all that. But because you believe in me, I have put my faith, my character, my ability inside you. Those who have that, lift your hands and praise God. How many of you acknowledge that you have Christ in you? If you have Christ in you, you have Him completely. Christ does not come to anybody 50%. He comes to you 100%. That means He has everything you have of Him. That is what this man says. Paul says, look guys, you have the Spirit which is of God. And the Holy Spirit is given to you that you might know the things that are freely given to you of God. There are things of God that has been given to you freely. You didn't pay any money for it. Whatever is required to have a solution. There's a big problem in the family. We don't know what to do. That solution is already inside you because of Jesus. That problem is going to go away because Christ is inside you. If Jesus were with living with you, that problem would have got over just like that. But the good news is Christ is already inside you, and the peace is already inside you, and the solution is already inside you. Hallelujah. Amen. In the book of Matthew, I'm encouraged to read a part from the book of Matthew. Here we go. Matthew chapter 28 tells me the story of a man who went through a field. How many of you know that story? Let's go to the book of Matthew. Matthew 13, 44. This is one verse which we preached at least 20 messages in one season of our mission trip. Just one word. We must have preached at least 20 messages. My God, people who did not know Malayalam or English, they were rejoicing and happy. Amen. Hallelujah. Look at this. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hid in a field, which when a man has found, he hideth, and for joy thereof goeth and selleth all that he has and buys that field. Please forget the eth and the ath and all that. That's old King James archaic English. Okay, read it like this. Again, the kingdom of heaven. Will you read it with me? The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hid in a field, which when a man has found, he hides it, and for joy thereof he goes and sells all that he has and buyeth that field. That means all that is required for your life is already put inside you. But you need to sell a lot of things to make sure that this comes out of you. I repeat this, every problem that you go through, if you are a child of God, God has already put it inside you that you may be able to solve that problem. You may be able to heal that sickness. I heal all my sickness. Hello. I have a revelation of healing. How many of you have a revelation that Jesus healed you 2000 years ago? How many of you know that Jesus healed even your great grandchildren that is yet to come? Now, for example, I want to tell you quickly. Let us imagine that Isaac, who is celebrating his birthday today, let's imagine Isaac's grandchildren. That means I'm thinking of who Isaac is going to marry. And I'm thinking of his children and his grandchildren. Did you know that Jesus has already healed them on the cross? Amen. And when you have the Holy Spirit freely teaches you how to heal yourself. Now, is there somebody here who can tell me how to heal yourself? Anybody, come on. We're going to give you a class on how to heal yourself. Is there anybody here who can tell me, Pastor, once in a while I get into a bout of depression and I don't know what to do. I will tell you what to do. Because Jesus has already put it inside our heart how to heal people, how to be healed. Anybody here who can tell me how to heal? I preach so many times. Because you have the word of God inside you, you keep on speaking the word of God. When you keep on speaking the word over your circumstance, the word of God, which has preeminence, takes over and destroys everything that is against your peace, everything against your happiness. That's how, somebody said amen. That is how we overcome. I know there are people sitting here, you have bouts of depression. You appear to be all right. But you can't fool two people. You can't fool God. And you can't fool a man of God who's got an X-ray scanning power. Somebody said hallelujah. Amen. The way to overcome is to speak the word of God. The way to heal is to speak the word of God. How many of you have heard this? But are you doing it? Praise God. God is pleased when you begin to work out on your problems. If 10 years ago you came into the kingdom of God with a problem, and after 10 years you have the same problem, people of God, today I want to tell you something a little difficult. God is not pleased with you because you are not using what God has already given to you. That is why God says, work out what God has. How many of you want God to be pleased with you? Any problem, any solution, anything that you need, for any problem, the solution is Jesus Christ. And Christ is inside you. Amen. So faith is working out what God has already given to you free. When I look back at the church and when I look back at the way God has led this church, I'm so excited to see the hand of God in every stage of our church growth. Someday before I go to be with Jesus, I have a desire to write this all down, intimate details, all the thoughts that I went through. You know, if God allows me, I want to write down. That will be a revelation for millions of people. Because what you see is not what it is. You are sitting there and you are seeing and observing a lot of things, but that is not what it is. There is a price being paid. There is a prayer being prayed. There is a life that is being set apart. There is a sacrifice that is being made. There is a decision that is being made every day. Because Christ has put something inside the heart of people. Amen. God, isn't it amazing? God gives you a brand new car and he teaches you how to drive. And then he tells you to go places. But you say, no. I will keep that beautiful car in my garage. It is so nice to see. You know, I'll open the garage every day, go near the car and shine it one more time. Touch it, look at it, look through the mirror and touch it and tell my friends, you know, I got a beautiful car. Then after all that, you put down the garage door and walk every day to the store. That is what Christians do every day. People of God come out of it. God has given you something awesome for you to drive on. You know, whenever I buy a new car, my new latest is, what is that? I don't even know the name of that. What is my new car? That one. That's coming on the way. I'll show you. But whenever I buy a new car, you know, I don't let anybody else touch it. If my children come near, I said, be careful. I don't want any scratch on that. My wife comes near, I said, be careful, okay? But after 2 months, anybody can use it. Hello? But there are people who never let anybody touch their car, their handbag, their purse, their mirror. Whoa, boy. You go somewhere near their handbag, they'll flare up like suddenly they'll flare up. They say, you can touch anything, don't touch my handbag. I'll kill you. If you really want to know the spirituality of a Christian, you just go and touch their handbag or purse. You'll know what their spirituality is like. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. For many people, the Spirit of the Lord like that. Are you baptized in the Spirit? I am baptized in the Holy Spirit. When I come inside the church, holy, 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 holy. But when I go, I have a problem in my family. It is not holy, holy. Something else is coming out of my mouth. Hallelujah. And God is not pleased with that. When you have a problem, financial problem, you say, I will go and tell some pastor, I'll go tell some preacher, pray for me. God says, I have put my Spirit in you. Why will you go before some man of God and make him an idol? I am your God. You know, people like me, we are known as the New Testament saints. Malayalam, we say, Pudhiya Neyama Punyavalan. We have a lot of people like that in the phone line. Many of you get into this phone line, Malayalam phone line. There are plenty of these saints. They all go to pastors, pray for us. It is good for pastors to pray for you. I love praying for people. But do not let pastors be God. Somebody said, hallelujah. The greatest idolatry today in the Christian world is not a statue. It is human beings. It is pastors. If a guy has some anointing, boy, that's it. He's God. When you have the same anointing, when you have the gift of praying, when you have the ability to release, when you have the ability to release the anointing, why will you fall at the feet of a man? Am I speaking sense this morning? You know the reason why many people will not be delivered is because of their stubbornness in thinking, this is the only way God can heal me, and this is the only way God will heal me. I want to tell you, God has another way of releasing you and redeeming you. Those who want can take it this morning. Yes, I'm telling you. Let me tell you this, New Testament church. Pastors and prophets can only point the way. They can also help you part of the way by asking the Lord to send the Holy Spirit upon you. But the rest is between you and God. God has put His Spirit in you. That is what it says here. Go back to 1 Corinthians 2:11. Let's take that word seriously today and say, Lord, you have given me free things. The Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit of God has given me free spirit of free things, and I want to use them. Amen. 1 Corinthians 2:12. Read this. Come on, church. Read for me together. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. How many of you have received the Holy Spirit? Please keep those hands up. There is nothing to be ashamed. In saying you have received the Holy Spirit. You have the Holy Spirit living inside you. Alright, right now, whatever your problem is, why don't you speak it over? Speak the Holy Spirit and the Word of God over your problem. Don't go back. I will not let you go off this hall until you are sure that your problem has been taken. Lock it. You're not going out of this hall in Jesus' name. Until and unless you acknowledge that you have the Holy Spirit. You know, I'm not here playing games. Because once you are inside the tabernacle of the Lord, you must go back with the Spirit of the Lord. You must go back with the assurance that God is with you. You must be able to take somebody else's burden and release them from them. If after years, after years, after years, you are still burdened with your problem, dear saints, it's not because God doesn't love you. It is not because you are not a good person. It is because you must learn to release the Spirit of God that is inside you. Amen. Hallelujah. That's what the Lord is telling me today to tell you. Let's stand up in God's presence. And let's say, Lord, fill me now. I have faith that I may release that faith. Thank you, Lord.